good to see everybody here today. Gonna give you a little bit of history of the church for our homecoming. We found out through the years there's not a whole lot of history that we have recorded on this church, but we do know that it was formed in 1797 down on Seneca Creek behind us, back down where the lake is now. Don't know the exact location, but that's all been documented. And where I'm standing right now, this part of the church has been here since 1802. And it's got hand-hewn beams in the attic. You can see where the beams were hewed by an axe or whatever they used back in those days. You can see the axe marks on it all the way from one end to the other. And when my dad came here to start this church back up at the request of some members that didn't move when they formed a new church, Hephzibah up the road up there, they just stayed with old Hephzibah, and although it was closed down, their heart was still here, and they met my dad over at Utica Mohawk when he went to work over there after he left the farm in 51, and put a new roof on this church, and rafters and all. They cut the pine trees off of the church's land right up here to my right, and had them sent to the sawmill, and that's what they used to put the rafters up on the roof. That's the last work that my grandpa Cromer was able to do. That's the last work he did before he passed away in 1953, was put a new roof on the church. And they made their own ladder out of 2x6s and 2x4s to climb up and down. I remember all that. I was 4 years old when Dad started pastoring here. And I've been attending this church through my marriage and raising my family and all. I've been here 69 years now. And I've seen a lot of good people come through here. A lot of them passed away, but I got a lot of memories, and some of you do as well. And we're gonna have some pictures to show you of the past homecomings, and one video of the 1968 homecoming will be on here that we can show you a good bit of a homecoming in 1968. And some of the people I was talking about that was here when we came here in 51 are on there. Grandpa, Granny McDonald, they're the oldest people you'll see on there. It won't be hard to pick them out, but they were good, loving people. They took care of their pastor. They gave him stuff out of the field. We ate good back in those days. Had fresh milk, buttermilk, homemade churned butter that they made right up the road here. If you left here, it'd be the first house on the left on Martin Creek Road after you leave here. But anyway, I spent a week at summertime, and they let us ride the mule and wagon up to another spot they had up the road to hoe corn and so forth like that. Me and Earl McDonald, we rode that wagon with Dennis and Grandpa McDonald, and that's before they ever had the little triangle placards they put on the back of slow-moving vehicles like they do now. But that's just good memories. If we go out here now, you can find muscadines in these trees out here. Well, I remember climbing these trees and eating muscadines and so forth when I spoke to be in Sunday school and stuff like that. And I might have had a licking or two for that, but we had some good times around here growing up. And like I say, I got married right here, right about where I'm standing, in 1965. And my daddy told us that he didn't expect us to come from Anderson up here to church, but he just wanted us to be in church somewhere. But we never left. This is home to us. And but I hope you enjoy the video of the homecomings of the past, and I think at the end of it, Brother Sean wanted to put a little bit of recent pictures on there, baptizing and so forth we had here recently in the past few weeks, one of them, but some of them's 2 or 3 years old. But that's what this church is all about, is seeing souls saved and helping people any way we can. So at this time, we'll start the portion of the video with the pictures, and we'll have a little bit of my dad preaching here in 1991, just for good memories. Thank you very much.
again, we bow our knees just as humble. And we go ahead and we thank God. Thank God the master we have called one more servant. Thank God the master needs us together now. Ask the good Lord to touch the needs and have a way. We praise God for them tonight. As we go to their best of men, the Lord is with us. Our Lord, all we request is pain. As God to meet the needs and not give the way. As all God in the days of the land of Jim. So Lord, let's us save the space we must do. Now push upon us all together. Lord, to that all the request. We ask God to be number one. And to have the best for the hearts of these servants. Oh God, we will in the mighty ways of that. And oh God can do it. God has the power. May Lord, I bless you, give all the requests to sing. The people, Lord, of His parish and meet God. Thank you again, your mercy and mercy. Leave it on your head this time. Have mercy upon each other. Lord, God, we bless you. Name of Jesus. That's the business that's with us again, Lord. Take every one of them. Before Jesus tonight. Lord, hallelujah. Thank you again for everything. In Jesus' name, praise God. Lord, thank you, Lord. Oh, thank God. Praise God. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
I've come.
Sister, as Shirley, And we've been having her, she's been the same woman good many years, hasn't she? So glad to have her with us. She, but somebody done acquainted with her, I just thought I'd tell you who she was. Glad to have Granny Smith, this is her first night in class. She was tonight for this service. And I'm thanking God for Granny Roberts. Been able to be here 3 solid nights straight, is that right? Yeah. And she's been a sick woman, you know, since she's been attending church the last few weeks, but she got better, she's here, but she's feeling bad tonight, she told me. I want to pray much for her. And Sister Carol, that's a poor soul, as we saw went by her house, they moved this season, and she was just about given out. You know, she had to go to the doctor, blood run up. Of course, she was in the hospital, Brown County, the week before last. She was weak, and she hadn't moved and everything. So you pray for Sister Carol, Junior, too. He's a poor old fella, you know, little fella, but you know, I call him little fella because he's so young, I mean, since a baby, so I guess it's for me to call him little fella. I want to say tonight we're so happy to have Tony and Rufus for the first time in the Bible. And we're glad to have them with us tonight, Tony and my daughter-in-law. Sure glad to Jan and Jimmy. I believe y'all got to be in this service. Well, Jimmy has been here every night. And you tell him that he went out again, don't see him. You tell him I certainly appreciate him being here helping us sing too. Have you sang, I mean. And Jan, this last night, first time. So she had to catch up with washing, you know. And some housewives sometimes working on public jobs too, and they can't tend to advise the rain like we can. But I appreciate her. It was every night. And I want you to pray much for the service tomorrow night and Sunday night, of course, Sunday morning. I expect to be here and have a good time Sunday morning.
Amen.
I don't believe the revival will close Sunday morning, even Brother Hart. I believe to be here Sunday morning. I really do. I think everybody has been revived, this revival. So
amen.
I thought I'd give you some scripture tonight. It's not easy to hear sometimes. It's not that I'm a good reader. It's not that I want to do something outstanding and tell you what we in, what mess we in tonight and nothing like that. But I'm going to tell you something tonight that it's wonderful how God can warn us. And Brother Harrison, all of everyone been warning people in this world for the last 40 years, you know, that Jesus is coming. And we see him coming, Brother John, right in the door.
Amen. That's right.
And so tonight, we're going to read the second chapter of 2 Peter tonight. If you'd like to read, but I want you to be much in prayer for the revival. We're going to start in Mount City, Georgia, this Monday night week coming, Monday night week. And I want you to pray for us. We get a prayer of those man with those people and pray that God would save souls. We don't know what might happen up there. We've been going to prayer once a month a good long while, and I tell you, we've had some awful good service. And it's wonderful how God has blessed us over there. And so, we're trying to go there once a month, but I want you to pray for this revival. It's been a long time since I had a revival out of the state of South Carolina. I want you to pray for that God would use over there. And so tonight, if you had the word, or if you had the Bible before you, turn, as I said, turn to 2 Peter, the second chapter. And I don't usually read this much. It's not that I'm a good reader, but the Lord laid on my heart as best I can with this chapter tonight. Begin to read the first verse. And there were false prophets among the people, even as there shall be false teachers among you, who proudly shall bring a damned hearsayers, even denying the Lord that brought them, and bring upon themselves swift destruction.
Amen.
And many shall follow the precise ways, by reason whom the way of truth shall be evil spoken of. And through covetousness shall they with these words make merchandise of you, whose judgment now of a long time lendeth not, and their damnation slumber not. For if God spare not the angels that sin, but cast them down to hell, and deliver them into the chains of darkness to be reserved unto judgment, and spare not the old world, but save Noah, the eighth person, a preacher of righteousness, bringing in the flood upon the world of the ungodly, and turn the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah, into ashes, condemning them with an open door, making them an example unto those that if they should live ungodly, and deliver just Lot, fixed with the filthy conversation of the wicked. For that righteous man dwelleth among them in sin, and here fixed his righteous soul from day to day with their unlawful deeds. The Lord knoweth how to deliver the young out of temptation, and reserve the unjust for the day of judgment to be punished, but chiefly them that walk after the flesh in the lust of uncleanness, despise government, presumptuous, or they self-will, they are not afraid to speak evil of deacons. Whereas angels which are greater in power and might bring not greater accusation against them before the Lord. But these are natural bruised pieces made to be taken and destroyed, speak evil of the things that they understand not, and shall utterly perish in their own corruption, and shall receive a reward of unrighteousness, as they that count it pleasure to write in the day, time, spots they are in the and plenty supporting themselves with their own deceiving, while they fast with you, feast with you, having eyes full of adultery, and that cannot cease from sin, beguiling unstable soul in heart, and the exercise with covetous practices, cursed children, while what which have forsaken the right way and are gone astray, following the way of Balaam, the son of Beor, who learned the ways of unrighteousness, but was rebuked of his iniquity, that I'm as speaking with man's voice, forbid the madness of the prophet. These are well without water, clouds that are carried with tempest, to whom the mist of darkness is reserved forever. I want you to notice that. Maybe I forget to say anything about that. But these, to whom the mist of darkness is reserved forever. You know, there's some people, Sister Casper, as doomed to die in burning hell.
Amen.
Amen. Faith, God, is what God will for them to get that way. But they made themselves that way.
Amen.
My friend and I, this homosexual, I heard Brother Charles preach on homosexual. I tell you, my friend, it's time that men was waking up. But when they speak great swelling words of vanity, they allow through the lust of the flesh, through much wanting, those that were clean escape from them who lived in it, while they promised them liberty, they themselves are the servants of corruption. All the same is brought into bondage. For after they have escaped the pollution of the world through the knowledge of the Lord, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, they are again entangled therein and overcome. The latter end is worse with them than the beginning. But it had been better for them not to have known the way of righteousness than if they had known it to turn from the holy commandment delivered unto them. But it happened unto them, according to the true proverb, the dog is turned to his own vomit again, and the sow that was washed turned water in the mouth or the mud. Well, that's the interpretation of mouth is mud. You know the thing about this? God Almighty tonight is looking for many women to stand in the camp of this world and preach the word, going to the call to preach against sin. I said tonight, my dear friend, and we think about this scripture tonight, I can preach truthfully. I believe I can preach all night on this tonight if I can hold out. I believe I could. I believe I can preach on the days of Noah, the days of Lot, my friend, all these things. And we can stay here all night.
Amen.
But what I want to do tonight, just get to the high points of this chapter, and we'll let you go right soon tonight. I haven't been holding you late, trying to get you out by maybe 8:30, where we have been, the other night, closed down about 8:30. I'm telling you tonight, God, my friend, God has a way for the righteous to escape the pollution of this world. God knows how. Well, I really tell you tonight, we'll have to preach the word the way that God wants us to preach it. Men and women is called to preach God's word. They're going to do it God's way, brother, or they'll not please God. And tonight I stand before you, and a little man don't know nothing outside what God gives me to preach, and I've got to preach it the way that God would have me to preach it tonight. And so, I tell you, brother Peter said, if there were false prophets among the people, and don't come, you know, in those days you're like going right now before they go. Amen. He said, why? And I'm trying just like going now, amongst you now, a teacher, bringing his sin, everything. I tell you, we have a lot of false prophets out, brother. It's amazing to me how people run from Jesus' blood when you talk about Jesus' blood. Oh, you'll be surprised. I tell you, yesterday, I'm not lying, brother. I saw men deceived like these men here and women, whoever they are, that's deceived like Billy, brother. Oh, they want to reward one righteous. They want to do the things of sin. I saw men run to me yesterday talking about Jesus. I know what I'm talking about. And I will tell you, brother, a false prophet come along, they'll listen to them. Amen. That's right. I know what I'm talking about. I'm mixing me with people I ever did the week together, and I live, I tell you, and they're maiming and tangling up with false teachers and false prophets. Brother, you let a man of God that's anointed the Holy Ghost in power go amongst these people, brother, that's never heard the truth the way that should be preached, and they're astonished at the power of God that comes from a prayer of a man that's anointed on one this morning.
Amen. Right.
You say, oh, we're leaving that time. You get around. You go out here and mix and mingle with the people, trying to get people right with God. You'll find out what I'm telling you.
Yeah, that's right.
You say, don't bother me. I'm telling you, my friend, you may never get out and ask people the same. I love my brother Arch here, what he says about speaking to people. Amen. That's what we ought to do. Everybody don't love us, you know.
That's right.
They never will. Everybody love us well. Even them, when they love me, if I preach like I'm doing now. Because I am trying to live. As I said the other night, walk in the footsteps of Jesus. Brother, if God spared me the angel of this sin, but cast them down, brother, in the chains of darkness be preserved under judgment, we know what judgment they're going to get, said the Casper. They're going to be turned in to the lake of fire being stoned, called Jesus, but power. Make the fire brimstone for this angel, brother. Well, for this world didn't need no hell, brother. When the devil up there in heaven, the position next to Jesus Christ, is the most beautiful angel, brother, up there, God created that way. He's been a liar since God created from what Jesus said. Amen. But I tell you, brother, now the third part of that star of heaven failed to this earth because the devil, the Bible said, true, the third part of this stars of heaven's tail in the 12th chapter of Revelation. Well, I tell you, he has a lot of power, but he don't have the power like my Christ, thank God. Well, no, he don't have the power like my Jesus. I don't know. I'm going to have to get out of this horse somehow or another. And all I know to do is to get my little duck here and put him right up here and get warmed up somehow or another. So excuse me. I'm trying.
Amen.
God will have a new this, I suppose. And I think he's teaching me how. And I'm just tired of the maneuver of the one that has his horses. Amen. Lord, he says, the devil has done this. No, the devil ain't done this to me tonight. It's just my position. It's just that I do a lot of talking and I do a lot of praying and I get hoarse sometimes. But it don't stop me from preaching. It's never since God called me to preach 40 over 1949. For if God's part of the age of him that sin, hey, my friend, he'll not spare you either if he's sin.
Right.
I tell you that. God don't love sin. God has never loved sin, brother. He never created this sin. As a reason, I said, God never, brother Charles, created
No home say so, brother. Well, they'll get mad at you sometime. They'll say, well, God made me this way. That's a lie from the devil. Amen. The devil would like all of us to be homosexuals, brother. He'd like all of us to turn from the natural use of the man to the woman and go to the same sex, brother. And they otherwise go in the church, be happy forevermore. He'd like us to do that. You know, the devil don't mind you join the church. He don't mind you get the church if you're just a preach a false doctrine. Amen. Teach a false doctrine. Sing a false doctrine, brother. Do what you want to do to please him. He won't bother you. You'll get on along all right. Did you know? Let me say. So help me. We have false prophets this Sunday, brother, coming. And tomorrow, Tuesday, tomorrow night, even 9 weeks somewhere in the world, they'll get the Bible. They'll get this King James Version. Some of you know. Amen. And they'll get this King James Version. And they'll soften up on it. They teach how to go around this. They won't preach on hell. They won't preach on everlasting fire. They won't preach a man going to burn in hell forever. I'm going to cross these Catholic people, brother, for teaching and doing these things. And I see them, they're doing a fine job. And sometimes I sit down and listen where the faults are. And brother, I find it pretty soon. A prophet, preacher, brother won't sit around too long with the false doctrine of the false Roman Catholic Church, brother, and ungodly denominator. Nation, people, brothers, are backing up with the money, everything. Yes, I tell you, I have to stay around too long until you find out, my friend, that they have a false doctrine. Just as sure as I'm here preaching tonight, they have a false doctrine, brother, and we have better let God's will. As the preacher told me the other day, he said, now let me tell you, preacher, he said, I am, and he's one of the word radio men. He said, I believe that we ought got to recognize in every denomination there are a good people. I say, yes, there are good people in every denomination. I said, I visit Catholic people, some of them are very nice and friendly, but I have visited other Catholic people, brother. They won't die to let me pray for those, their members. They won't die to let me pray for them even when they get these home, brother. I have some right now. They say, I have my preacher, and I don't want you to pray for me. My preacher tells me to not let nobody else pray for me. And I'm telling you, brother, that's a rock on me. That's a hellish doctor right there. If I've ever heard in my life, because Jesus told us to pray for everybody, love everybody, brother. We've got to love these false prophets and pray for them while we have this breath in us, while we're here, brother, while we're here. But we're going to be taken out of here one of these days, and they're going to be left, brother, to go through some of them through this whole time of the tribulation. And then they are going to be in the midst of darkness forever and ever. Knowing these people, brother, rebel against God like Baal did, my friend, they will never, never get out of the lake of fire and brimstone, brother Horse. Will they go there? No, nobody, my friend, will go there. That's sin. The only way you get to heaven is to repent of sin, be born again, as you said the other night, brother. Be born again. Oh, that was brother Charles one time said that. I don't know if he said that, but he said it. He said, brother, I tell you, it's that soul. His soul. You've got to be born of the water and spirit before you ever get to heaven. And no man that hasn't repented of sin can get there. You mark that down. I'm going to tell you, but God Almighty's fired up the angel of sin. And I'm going to tell you another thing. He's fired up the old world of the weakness of fornication, of filth, and abomination, and the homosexual, everything else. And all of these things, brother, they're done as way. God did not spare that old world, brother. He brought in a flood, and you know that, read to you tonight. It spared not the old world, the Bible said. Look at that, what it said. But say, Noah, glory. The eighth person, glory to God. You know, right there, plus in the head, he's the head of the family, wasn't he? The eighth person, and he had three sons and three wives. Glory, hallelujah. And that's the only one that saved out of millions of people upon this earth was Noah, the eighth person, and his wife, and Noah's three sons and their wife. Brother Charles has said this, I'm going to say it again. Noah's son didn't have one wife, did they? Amen. And he didn't have one wife. So I'm telling you, brother, you can't take two wives to heaven with you when you go. You better die with one And that better be the one you married. And if she's still living, talking about, oh, well, you won't go in. Yeah, I'm sorry to say that to somebody. But anyhow, saying this adulterous generation, Brother Charles, they're going to hell, they don't repent of sin and get where God can take them into heaven. Oh, brother, I'm genuine tonight. It's time that man was waking up. Spare not the angel. Spare not the old world. My friend, I'm going to tell you another thing. He spared not Sodom and Gomorrah, did he? Brother, otherwise, Brother Sean, I heard you say, otherwise, those homosexuals, brother, they wanted even old Lot, brother, and the angels that went down there. They wanted those angels, brother. I'm telling you, it's time. Otherwise, they thought two men were in there. Amen. Amen. And old Lot had two virgin daughters, my friend. And he loved those men, those angels of God, more than the left. Otherwise, he loved them more. That is, he loved God, but that way, more than those two. Well, he loved the angels more than he loved his two daughters. Now, that's the way we have to be. When we serve God, we have got to say everything but God. If you love father, mother, sister, brother, wife, boy, you love Jesus, you're not willing, and you know that. My friend, come down the place, deny my Lord, or deny my children, my wife, my husband, or you deny your husband. I will say, let me have Jesus. God will take care of my wife and children from hell. Let me have Jesus, because I am not going to deny him if I die for it. If I don't die, it's my duty, brother, my children may go to hell. But if I will, if God will be done, everything will be all right. Now and then, and to live in just one fix with a filthy conversation of the wicked. Have you ever went around where the cousin is swearing? Oh, brother, amen, you can't help sometimes to hear some of that filthy stuff, brother. Well, I don't hear too much of it because I don't hang around long enough. Amen. That's right. When I get to talk to a bunch of people, they're going to talk about politics and worldly junk and ball games and everything like that. You know what I do? I just walk out.
Amen. That's right.
I went to the barbershop and waste the time myself. I go over 2 weeks. Amen. 2 weeks ago to the bar. And one of them smart-headed barbers up there. I come to smart-headed. He's acting like he loves me. But anyhow, at the barbershop, was poor man away. Had to wait a good while. And here he popped out. The first thing he asked me, he said, a preacher, you're going to have a big ball game this evening. Look at me. I'll tell you what he told me. I said, man, let me tell you, no, I'm not going to the ball game this evening. I'm going to fishing. Woo! I said, I'm going to fishing. Going to fishing in that ball game going on. I said, yeah, I'm going to fishing. He said, I said, tonight, you going to show up, you're fishing, preacher. I said, did you, don't you know what Jesus told Peter? He said, I'll make you a fisherman of men.
Amen.
I'll make you a fisherman of men. I said, look at me so funny. And brother, there's two men, two people sitting there, one there, one in the chair, away from that chair. And he looked at me. I said, you know what I done last week? When I said this week, I said, yeah, this week. I said, this week. I said, I caught two. When before they were all there, people looking at me, I was preaching tonight. They looked at me. I said, yes, I caught two. He said, how big was it? I said, well, I don't know how big the Olson was, but I said he had white hair and a long, and I think he had a mustache and a white beard. And I said, the other must have been 40, 50 years old, and he's showing pretty good sized fish. And he said, come on there now, you tell me, what you talking about? You're trying to stick me. I said, no, I'm a fisherman. I said, one man by 85 years old, ain't your sweetheart beer 85 years old, man? Well, can't you back me up? Don't be ashamed of his age. Don't let him tell a story. 85.
Amen.
Oh, glory, she didn't know what I was talking about. She thought I was talking about a beer and fish dish. Well, that's the kind of fishing I love to do, brother. I don't care about these clips of ball games. It's up to me. I'd go there and put a stick of dynamite on those seats. And I'd destroy every one of them. You say, would you do them poor fellow that way if I see that? Yes, I would. But I wouldn't want to be over there. Now, don't get me wrong. Go there and say, there's a preacher over there. He's going to church over there. And he's going to like put some dynamite on that thing and blow it sky high.
Amen. Amen.
I don't know when they're going to have the next game, but they get blown up hard, and everything will be over. I can't teach you that. Well, it could be the one of us happening. I'm like, well, I'd be in trouble. Oh, they say, yeah. Oh, yeah. Somebody go over there. Oh, that preacher said they're going to do that. I heard him say the pulpit and have all those weapons. He knows he said it. Boy, you can get trouble that way. Well, with all that, I would want the Air Force to go and bomb it.
That's it, boy.
That settled that. But I tell you, my friend, this nothing, ball game don't mean nothing to me. Like we used to play and get out, knocked down, and dragged out, run on the barbed wire fences and everything else. That was all right. Amen. We weren't out there playing and trying to outdo this Carolina or South Carolina, whatever, Georgia, Texas, whatever. We weren't trying to do that. When you get up there, brother, whether, amen, there are preachers out there, deacons out there, and they'll holler, oh, woo, what is that? Go get it, boy.
Amen. That's what they're doing.
Let some of these priests and deacons come in church next Sunday morning. There's horses I am preaching here. Oh, yeah. I tell you, brother, this world and stuff like that will send you to hell if you sell out to it.
Amen.
See, I don't have to go to the state over there looking. No, you don't. Oh, you see, I'm telling me, I know that I don't really realize. I don't really understand why a man gives someone $75 ticket to the front seat and set the living room seat the same day. Right. I mean, I don't. Hey, brother, that ain't hard. Why won't I change you to something? Oh, well, that's unrighteous. A lot of people learn it's a way of being, brother. Amen. Unrighteous. Oh, we don't love those things. God, I read to you the other day. We don't love the things the way we are. A different bunch of people. The same people are supposed to look different, dress different, talk different, and everything.
That's your
Lord. Oh, yeah. You say, I'm not that way. I want to mix and mingle with. Go ahead. You want to go the way I love better, brother? Go ahead. Love the place of sin. And after a while, you suffer as sure as I'm here tonight.
Amen.
Oh, my God. People are suffering tonight. Because they don't have enough of God in them to shout the victory when they have these good old times. They don't have time because they're sapped to death. Devil's sapped out of them.
Praise God.
And right, you say, I don't believe it. I tell you, brother, when I felt this revival, even before I had this revival, brother, I wouldn't give an hour of it for all the music of men, whatever you call it, in this world for 10 weeks. You can pay my fine, my friend, anywhere, any state of, amen, and give me a friend you kind of like to drag and won't tell me we want to stand for a solid year and say, enjoy yourself. I say, you keep your money. I go to a Hepsi church and I'll preach that. Where you go, preach, brother, and I'll have a better time with the money I have and I'll be happy. And when Jesus comes, woo, it's going to be joy and peace beyond
measure.
Amen. Isn't that good?
Amen.
Well, these people says, I'm trying up tonight. Let me tell you.
Amen.
I wish in the good Lord I had a telephone here. Or something I have my ever have every living room or every place picked where they are listening to that and just listen to what they're listening to. That's right. I prayed today and God showed me. I believe God showed me that. He says, son, you warned the people. You put that poster and everything else. You warned the people. You told your members to come on. And some of them have been here. And I'm not scared to sit in the face of nothing. I want God to save their children and their grandchildren. They've not got enough of grace and enough of God to get out of that seat and come down to church.
Amen. That's right.
Oh, yeah. They say, we got to rest. We got to rest. Well, my Lord, my friend, I get more rest here in this house of God, when you're in the house of God, where the Spirit of God is at, than anything, any place that I know.
Amen.
This is where you get rest.
Amen.
He was telling me a lot of times, hey, you're going to kill yourself. I said, no, I'm not. As long as I do God's will, I'm going to live forever. You say, I don't believe you do. I tell you, I can work all day and anything. Be give out. Come here for night service and get. Boy, I feel so blessed up tonight. I am kidding. truth, my dear friend. I feel rested up when I get here. And I give out on the job sometimes, but come here, I'm rested. And I tell you, brother, I could come here tonight, glory to God, and preach an hour, brother. Go home, and I'm so round up and so full of that message, brother, until I might not sleep 2 hours that night. Get up next morning, thank God. Go on, just like I had a 12-hour sleep. Feel better than I did when I taking a red cap to sleep 12, 15 hours sometimes. Man, I got a taste of the. Well, you know, I preached on that field. Oh, Jesus, and I have been, as you know, not off. And he said, otherwise, he told me to preach on that. And I tell you, brother, when you get to eating on this meat, now when you get to living right, doing what God wants you to do, eating on this meat, everything here. Now I got to go ahead. I can't come all this night. I've covered some, but let me tell you just a little bit about this. For if they have escaped the pollution of the world through the knowledge of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Now, when you've done that, my friend, keep going on. Don't get to think you know it all, but you go on and on and on. And tell people that we got to live a holy life, or we will be like these people.
Amen. That's right.
I don't believe in preachers that live in the way to get to hell. And Savior Jesus Christ, they are again entangled our end and overcome. Let me tell you, there's people of mine that one time shouted the victory, Brother Morgan. I know what I'm talking about. I know, because the witnesses, they shouted the victory. And the old devil overcome. And they become polluted with the world again.
Amen.
They entangle themselves with pleasure, sin pleasure of this world. They tell me that. My friend, they're so cold and a lot of sick and can't do nothing younger than I am. And I'm not saying Christian people don't get sick. Don't misunderstand me. And I'm going to tell you, brother, when you entangle yourself with this old world of things, you know God, you've tasted of God, you've overcome the pollution of the world through the knowledge of God, through that what? That knowledge of wisdom that God gave you, and all of a sudden you want to go your way, and not that God's will be done, and you've been tangling yourself again with this old filthy stuff. And I tell you, brother, otherwise it's time that people realize that the devil has power next to Jesus, and you can't play around with him, brother. You can't deal and dabble around with him. Every time you get a change of God, a Holy Ghost meeting, brother, where's the Baptist church, Holiness church, whatever. Preaching the true words of God. Get by missing the pastor that has anointed, the badges of the Lord, and hear that man. Because if you don't, you may wake up somewhere that you don't want to go to. I tell you that right now.
Amen. That's right.
If God's found out the end, it had been better for them not to have known the way of truth of righteousness. It had been better for them not to have known the way of righteousness than ever that they have known it. To turn from the holy of man, delivered unto them. But it happened when Satan goes. One verse, one verse, just read that last verse one more time. But it happened unto them, according to the true proverb, the dog is turned to his own vomit again. And the sound that was washed in a water in the mire, in the mud. Oh, I see drunkards sometimes. It's saved to tell me. Brother, they're watering the mud tonight. They're watering the mire. Because it's simply that devil overdoing
it. Amen.
Amen. And I want to quote this verse in Revelation, the 12th chapter. They overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of the testimony. Because they loved not the life of the dead.
Amen. Amen.
Brother, that's talking about the life of sin. But they overcame it. And why, Brother Charles Stinnett, I ask you this. How in the world can our members stay home and not come down here and go to your church? And these are the other churches. Why can't they go and testify if they have an opportunity before the people? And you know, you show forth Jesus' death by baptism. You also show forth that you're an overcomer by your testimony. You overcame him with the blood of the Lamb, by the word of the testimony. I have a lot of members just come in prayer meeting, brother. And tonight they're home looking to tell me they're too busy. They say they work to death. Want to slow down some and go to the house of God. Amen. If you get a chance to go, you better go. Because you'll be on your own old mind again. If you want, don't watch yourself. Come on, just stand. Come on, sing that song tonight. 577. 577. 575. I want everybody to sing this song with us tonight. Please, please, please turn there. 573. Turn to 573. Yes, all the same. Yeah. 573.